So IVF started as in vitro fertilization, that's what it stands for. And when it began, the only way to fertilize an egg in vitro was simply to add sperm to the petri dish where the egg is. And so the sperm surrounded the egg and essentially swam up to the egg and penetrated the shell around the egg and entered the egg on their own. So you could call it natural fertilization, natural in the sense that the sperm got in the egg on its own. ICSI, or ICSI, is where we take a single sperm and literally inject it into the egg with a needle. And there the sperm doesn't have to penetrate the shell and get in the egg. The sperm sort of has its work done for it. And of course, ICSI can be done with low sperm count, low motility, low morphology, any kind of sperm issue. ICSI can often circumvent that. And so many, many cycles now are done with ICSI. In fact, the majority are done with ICSI, because occasionally the sperm actually look normal, but if you just add them to the egg, there's no fertilization. And then you realize the sperm did have a defect at penetrating the shell. But in that case, the whole cycle is lost. The woman's gone through the drug, she's had an egg retrieval, and now none of her eggs have fertilized. So we tend to do ICSI almost as a precaution more often now when there's any question about the sperm, so that we don't risk fertilization failure. So the couple's sure they're gonna have eggs fertilized, and they're sure they're gonna have embryos growing, and at least a chance to have a healthy outcome from their IVF cycle.